friends, what's up? Today I'm going to show you how to make a really good blueberry banana shake smoothie. It's one of my favorites. It's very simple. You only need 4 ingredients, but you could possibly add 2 more ingredients, so a total 6 if you want more flavor in there. So the basics that I start with is Greek yogurt. Some blueberries, a banana, 1 banana, and almond milk. So, and you'll also need a mixer. So I have a Nutribullet, that's really good. And that's what I need. Okay, so I do 1 cup of almond milk. And I love using almond milk. It tastes much better than the regular normal milk from a cow. And the thing that I really like about it is that it lasts much longer than the regular milk, like a lot longer. It lasts like 3 months once you buy it from the store. So it just, like, I would always buy the gallon milk before, the regular milk, and I would just waste like half of it because I'm single and I live on my own. So here's a little tip for you. Use almond milk because it lasts longer. Okay, I'm going to use a spoon, 1 cup of Greek yogurt. Okay. One cup of this Greek yogurt, and I like this Greek yogurt because it serves, it makes your shake a little bit thicker. It makes your shake thicker, and then there's also protein in it. But the thing about that is that it's very plain, so it's kind of, you use it as a base. So just keep in mind, if you don't do anything to sweeten it, it tastes kind of bland. So for me, I like to put in, this is when I said you can use 4 or 6 ingredients. I like to put in some vanilla extract. I like to put in some vanilla extract, just a few drops in there, and then like 1 drop of cinnamon in there as well. Because if you don't put it in there, then it tastes, like I said, it's very, there's not much flavor to it. I just like to do a few drops in there. Give it some flavor. And just 1 little sprinkle of cinnamon. You see? Well, I don't want to drop it. Okay. Then I'll take like 1/4 cup of blueberries. Rinse them. Last 1. Okay, I'm gonna put that in there. I'm gonna do almost 2 cups. I just do 1/2 of a banana so I can save the rest of it for tomorrow morning. Okay. I just throw the whole thing in there. The thing is, you definitely want to make sure that you have enough liquid in there, because if you don't have enough liquid, it's not going to, for one, you could hurt your blender, and for two, you just want your shake to be a little more liquidy. Shake it up to make sure that the cream gets to the bottom. Shake, shake, shake. Okay. There you have it. You have a, oh my gosh, this shake is so good. Let me try. It's delicious. Oh, okay, so good. Yep, so the beautiful thing about this is that once you have all those ingredients, you can use the same ingredients to the next day. Or, yeah, like for tonight, you can use the same ingredients to make oatmeal, old-fashioned oatmeal. It's the same thing, but you just pour in your oatmeal and you let it sit overnight. Maybe I should do a video for that. Maybe I'll do that tomorrow, a new video. But basically, because for me, I don't, like I said, I'm single and I don't like to waste my ingredients. So once I have my base ingredients for my shake, it's good because I can also use the exact same ingredients plus the oatmeal. Make sure it's old-fashioned oatmeal, if you get it. And you can use that for a snack in the morning, and that way you know that you're using all your ingredients, because I hate wasting my ingredients. So yeah, try it and let me know what you think about it, but it's delicious. I highly recommend it. Thanks for watching. Have a good day.